आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव।
आजादी का सफर विद AIR न्यूज, बर्थ ऑफ अ नेशन।
India's glorious freedom struggle is one of the greatest struggles the modern world has ever witnessed. AIR News brings you a glimpse of the struggle every day.
In today's episode, we remember educationist and Gandhian freedom fighter Saifuddin Kichlu, who was born on the 15th of January 1888 in Amritsar, Punjab. Kichlu devoted his life to preserving communal harmony in India and was at the forefront of the protests against the Rowlatt Act in Amritsar.
A lawyer by profession, Kichlu, alongside fellow freedom fighter Satyapal, led a strike to agitate people against British oppression. In a public gathering in Amritsar on 30th March 1919, addressing a gathering of 30,000 people, he said,
"The message of Mahatma Gandhi has been read to you. All citizens should be prepared for resistance. This does not mean that this sacred town or country should be flooded with blood. The resistance should be a passive one. Do not use harsh words in respect of any policeman or traitor, which might cause him pain or lead to the possibility of a breach of peace."
The British were alarmed by the growing resistance against the Rowlatt Act, and they arrested Kichlu and Satyapal on the 10th April and sent them to Dharamshala. Their arrests triggered the mass gathering at Jallianwala Bagh, which was violently crushed by General Dyer, massacring hundreds of innocent people on 13th April 1919. Kichlu was eventually released from prison in December 1919.
Kichlu was instrumental in the establishment of Swaraj Ashram in January 1921 at Amritsar to train young men for national work and to promote Hindu-Muslim unity. Saifuddin Kichlu was repeatedly arrested by the British authorities and spent a total of 14 years in jail.
Kichlu was also the chairman of the reception committee of the Congress session in Lahore when, on 26 January 1930, the Indian National Congress declared Indian independence. Kichlu was supporter of Bhagat Singh and was actively involved with him in Naujawan Bharat Sabha. He was also a member of the foundation committee of Jamia Millia Islamia.
In 1947, Kichlu strongly opposed the acceptance of the partition of India. He spoke out against it at public meetings across the country. He called it a blatant surrender of nationalism for communalism. He was the founder president of the All India Peace Council, besides remaining vice president of the World Peace Council.
He received the Stalin Peace Prize in 1952. In 1951, the government of India made Kichlu, along with Jawaharlal Nehru and Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, life trustees of the Jallianwala Bagh National Memorial Trust. He died on 9th October 1963. We salute the great nationalist.
We also remember social reformer Ram Gopal Ghosh, who died on 15 January 1868. One of the leaders of the Young Bengal group, he was referred to as Indian Demosthenes, comparing him to the Greek statesman of ancient Athens. Ghosh also helped in the establishment of Bethune College in 1879, which was the first women's college in India as well as in Asia.
Ram Gopal Ghosh joined the class of radical thinker Henry D'Orozio and soon became friendly with Ramtanu Lahiri and the other D'Orozians. When D'Orozio established the Academic Association, Ghosh became one of its leading members. In 1853, he was among the first to demand the eligibility of Indians in the civil service examinations.
In 1854, he proposed the establishment of universities in India. Ram Gopal Ghosh took an active part in the establishment of the British Indian Association. We salute the great Indian.
That brings us to the end of this episode of Azadi Ka Safar with AIR News. See you in the next episode tomorrow.